Hello, good morning friends. Myself Sridhar H, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication at Government Engineering College, Haveri. Today we are just going with the basic electronics, that is 18 ELN 14R24 of module 5, that is digital electronics fundamentals. In this session we are just going with the number system. Okay, so what are the things what you people will be studying in the module 5 is, so in this just going through the difference between analog and digital signals, so number systems, so convergence between binary to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to hexadecimals to binary, hexadecimal as well as vice versa. Along with that, we'll just going with the Boolean algebra, basics and universal gates, later its applications, half adder, full adder, multiplexer, decoders, then the sequential circuits, that is flip-flops. In that applications, we'll just going with the shift registers as well as the 3-bit ripple counters. And later, at the last session, we people are going with the basic communication system and its operations. Okay, so in this session, we are just going with the digital systems, binary, number based version, as well as octal and hexadecimal numbers. Okay, so first, so what does this mean by digital electronics? As we know that the whole world today, the whole world is being dependent upon this digital system. So wherever we go, we'll just going with the digital products in a normal life. So we can take any of the, if we just take the vehicles also, there also will be using the digital things. In your home appliance also, we people have been using with the digital things. Okay, so next, the digital circuits and the digital system. Okay, so in this digital system, we are just, all the digital circuits will be having only the two values, high value or the low value. See, high value or the low value. High value is being represented with the logic 1, or it is also known as the close switch or as a on state. Okay, in the same fashion, with the logical low value means logic 0. So logic 0 means it's a open switch, that is a off state. So we'll be having only two states, on state or the off state, or close switch or the open switch, or logic 1 or logic 0, or high and low. Okay, so this one is the thing. So it will be represented with 0 volts as well as the plus 5 volts or the 1 value. Next, digital system and the binary numbers. Okay, so first, the digital computers. So general purpose, we are using the computer for the general purpose as well as the many scientific, that is the application, that is industrial as well as the commercial applications. So now, what are the things, the digital systems what you people will be using is the telephone switching exchanges, digital cameras, electronic calculators, PDAs, as well as the digital TV. So we can name all the products whatever people are using generally now are all being used with the digital part. It might be your mobile phones, or it might be your laptops or systems, your digital watches, your calculators, your washing machines, or any of the home appliances we take will be using the digital part. Okay, next, the discrete info processing systems are, so manipulation discrete elements of information, for example 1, 2, 3 as well as the ABC. Normally these things will be just coming in a deeper part what will people going with the digital things. Next, the binary digital signal, an information variable represented by physical quantity. Okay, so whatever the binary digital system means, information will represent by the physical, means physical quantity means it will be having the representing the values. So it might be a 0 or 1. So normally the binary system will be having only two values, two levels or two values, that is one is 0 and another one is 1. So that is binary are represented abstractly by digit 0 and 1. So next, so the word 0 is represented by what? The false term it might be, and the 1 will be representing by the true. As already in the previous session, previous slide we just went through, digital 0 means it is represented by low, and 1 means it is represented by high, and another one is, so whether if it is 0 means it is in a off state, and 1 means it is in a on state. Okay, depending upon the design it can be changed. Okay, next, binary values are represented by values or ranges of values of the physical quantity. So we'll be always having the ranges, whatever that means. Always the initial part will be represented by zero, and the physical quantity can be varied. So if you're just going with the plus 5 volts, then we'll be telling it as, so the voltage has been varying from 0 to +5 volts. Next, so main difference between the analog and the digital signal. Signal. Analog signal is a continuous signal which has infinite number of waves or values in a range. See, analog system is a continuous signal. So it will be having a continuous signal and it will be having an infinite number of values in a range. So it might be variable or it might be a constant. Next, the digital signals are discrete time signals, have limited values 0 and 1 in a range here. So this is the digital system. It is having a discrete values and it will be having only two values, 0 and 1. So if you just consider this as a clock, then it will be having a 0, 1, 1. It's a continuous one. So the sine wave, if you just take it, so this is represented by a square wave. That is, analog signal has been represented by sine wave and the digital signal has been represented by the square wave. Okay, so in a sine wave, if you just represent the discrete value, so this is the thing what it will be looking in the form of this sine wave when it has been converted into a digital. So the same difference is continuous, that is analog system as well as the digital system. Analog system uses continuous range of values to represent information, but the digital system uses discrete or discontinuous values to represent information. Analog systems are, examples are your human voice in air, analog electronic devices, what we people are been just studying. The examples are human voice in air, analog as well as the digital analog electronic devices. And the digital systems are computers, CDs, DVDs and digital electronic devices. And analog system, noise easily get affected, means it will be having heavy noise, but in digital circuits we will be having a less effect of noise. Okay, the advantages of digital signal over analog signal is easy to ease of design, and it is data production, programmable, speedy, economy as well as quality. For that reason only, the all the products whatever you people have been designed right now are in our digital things because of its, so it's easier to design, so its data is being protected and it can be easily programmable and it's very speed and it's economy as well as its grand quality. Okay, number system, so it will be having the four parts: decimal, binary, octal as well as hexadecimal. Okay, decimal means it will be representing the term as base 10. Any number to the base 10 is being represented as a decimal thing. So it is having its number from 0 to 9. Okay, as well as, so decimal numbers is normally used by the human beings but not been used in a computers, as well as the binary. So binary means, as you already know, that it is having only two values, that is 0 and 1. Normally these are not been used by the human beings, only the computers will be using this. As well as the next is octal. Octal means to the base 8, so it is having the number from 0 to 7, and it is not being used by both human beings as well as the computers. And next is the hexadecimal. So hexadecimal means to the base 16, so these are represented from the number 0 to 15. Okay, but only the important thing what you should remember in hexadecimal means 0 to 9 it is mean common, and the number 10 is been represented with the alphabet A, 11 by B, 12 by C, 13 by D, 14 by E and 15 by F. Okay, the 10, 11, 12, 13 and 15 are been represented by the alphabetic letters A, B, C, D, E and F. Okay, respectively, and this also it is not being used by the human beings nor by the computers. Okay, in this four terms, the only the decimal part is being used by the human beings and the binary part is being used by the computers. Next, so this is the next, we'll just go with the decimal number system. As we already told that the base will be having of a 10, that is, so it's called a radix. So 10 digits are in the numbers are 0 to 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 8 and 9. The digital position, so it has been having the two parts, or it's normally it is represented by the integer and fraction. So any terms beside this one is known as the, that is 512 is known as the integer, 0.74 is known as your fraction part. Okay, so base, so digit weight, weight is equal to base to the position. Okay, base means, so what is the 10 whatever you have been taking, this as the base. Position means, so it is been represented by the terms. So of before dot, it is been represented by what? 0, 1, 2. Okay, and after, in the fractional part, it is been represented by minus 1, minus 2. So that is the base to the position. And magnitude is equal to the sum of digit x into weight, that is digit into weight. So that is, the formula is d2 into base square plus d1 into base to the power of 1 plus d0 into b0, that is base to the 0, plus d1 into base to the minus 1 and d2 into base to the minus 2. So if you just take a normal formal notation or the normal example, so what it is saying is 512. So 2 is the term unit base. Okay, so it is been represented by 10 raised to the power of 0. Its value is 1. So 1 into 10 raised to power of 1. 10 raised to power is, its value is 1. So next is 100, means 10 raised to the power of square, that is 10 square is 100. So in this fashion, if we just take the after fraction part, 10 raised to minus 1 is 0.1, 10 raised to minus 2 is 0.01. Okay, so we are just multiplying this 5 into 100, its value, that is sum into digit into weight. 5 into 100 is what? 500. 1 into 10 is 10. 2 into 1 is 2.7 into 0.1 is 0.7, and 4 into 0.01 is 0.04. If you just add up all these terms in the, by using this formula, then it will be getting 500 plus 10 plus 2, that is 512.74 plus 0.704 is 0.74 to the base 10. So this is just the representation of the decimal number, that is 512.74. Next, octal number, the same thing. So instead of base, the previous slide, so it has been 10. So here it is base to the 8. So its digits have been represented by what? The term 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. The formula will be the same, that is the weight is base to the position, that is base to the position means, so in this base it will be having 8 to the position, that is 8 raised to 0 is what? 1 value. 8 raised to 1 is 8. 8 raised to 2 is 8 square, that is 64. Okay, its value they have given 1, 8 and 2. In the previous slide they have just changed the what? 0, 1, 2 at the top, and the value will be written here in the previous next slide. That is, octal is what? To the base is what? Base is 8 raised to 0, position is 0, its value will be what? 1, 8 raised to 1 is 8 and 8 square is 64. For the same number, that is 512, what's value will be what? 5 into 8 square plus 1 into 8 plus 2 into 1, 0.7 into 1 by 8, that is 8 inverse, plus 4 into 8 raised to minus 2, that is 1 by 64. If we just add up all these terms, we will be getting it as 330.9375 to the base 10. Okay, and its value will be what? 512.74 to the base 8. Next, binary system is same thing. Its base will be what? 2, and it is always represented by values only 2 digits, that is 0 and 1, and its binary digits are bits. So base to the position is same, as well as the magnitude will be what? 7 into bit into weight, or the digit into weight. Okay, so that is, so this one is the position. 2 raised to 0 is what? 1. 2 raised to 1 is 2. 2 raised to 2 is 4, that is 2 square is 4. 2 raised to 1 is, that is 2 raised to 1 is 2 value. So these are the values what will be having. 2 raised to minus 1 is 1 by 2. 2 raised to minus 2 is 1. So we are just adding up with the 1, that is 1 into 4 plus 0 into 2 and 1 into 1, that is 4 plus 1 will be what? 5 point. So its value will be what? 0.25. Okay, so 5.25 to the base 10. So whatever the number, what you can converting into a decimal terms from the binary value, that is 101.01 to the base 2. Okay, and now there is a group of bits, 4 bits will always be represented by nibble, and 8 bits is equal to what? It is represented as byte. So next is the hexadecimal. So what are the processes, whatever we people have followed for the decimal, octal or the binary, the same thing is the thing. Only thing is what? So it will be having a 16 digits, that is 0 to 9 is be common, and 10 is be represented by A, 11 is by B, 12 by C, 13 by D, 14 by E, and 15 by F. Okay, the same base to the position, digit into width, that is the magnitude, that is 16 raised to 0 is what? 1. 16 raised to 1 is 16. 16 square is what? 256. 16 raised to minus 1 as well as plus 16 raised to minus 2. So they are given the value, it as 1E5. So we are just multiplying with the terms. 1 into 16 square, that is 256, plus E value will be represented by what value? That is 14. 14 into 16 raised to 1 plus 5 into 16 raised to 0, that is 1 into 256 plus 14 into 16 plus 5 into 1.7 into 16 raised to minus 1 plus A value is 10 into 16 raised to minus 2. So this is the thing what they are given, and if you add up, we will be getting it as 485.4765625 to the base 10. So the value of 1E5.7578 to the base 16, its decimal value up to the base 10 value is what? 485.4765625. Okay, so this one is the number of conversions from any of the base to the decimal number, that is to the base 10. Next, so what are the steps for conversion? So first is the integer part as well as the fractional part. So we are converting from the decimal to any of the form. So next, successive division division will be going on for this integer part, and for fractional part it will be successive multiplication. So later it will be explained by the step-by-step procedure. Okay, next. So this one just the theoretical part, just to remember. Divide decimal integer number by the radix of the number system converted. So whatever the number to be is converted to the base 8 or to the base octal, to the binary or to the exam, depending on that radix value, people will be dividing the number whatever they have been given. In the same fashion, for fractional part, we will be just doing the successive multiplication, that is the number of the radix of the number system to be converted. Okay, next. So if you just go on dividing, then you will be having both terms, quotient as well as the remainder. So we will be just concentrating from the remainder thing, and the quotient will be once again divided by the radix part. So we are just concentrating on the what? The remainder part, and it is been represented by the bottom to top. Okay, so while explaining the example, you will be coming to know. And the same, the whole number integer as well as the read remainder from top to bottom. For the what? For integer part, we people are going from bottom to top, and for fractional part, we are getting from top to bottom. So these steps have been followed continuously until we get the zero term or any other term which has been not been divided by the terms. Again, the same fashion, steps have been repeated, that is 192 steps have been repeated continuously until the desired position. Next. So these are just the decimal to other number system. So we can convert to any numbers to the any form. So that is, we are just converting from decimal to binary, decimal to octal, as well as decimal to hexadecimal, or it can be converted from what? Binary to decimal, octal to decimal, hexadecimal to hexadecimal to decimal. So these are all the vice versa, means we can convert any of the numbers to the any of the decimal form or the number system. Next, the first example, convert the decimal number 294 to the binary. Okay, so 294 to the base 10 to binary. So binary means we should convert to the base 2. So the radix part is what here? 2. So if you just consider the previous thing, see, radix part is 2, and it should be going on continuously dividing by the number with the radix point. So here the radix point is what, the 2, so it should be converting to a binary. So what we are doing is 294 divided by 2 means its results, the quotient part is 147 and the remainder will be 0. So we are just concentrating on the binary value, that is the remainder value, that we are just taking out as 0. Next, so the same quotient, that is 147, whatever we got the thing, that we are once again dividing by 2. So we are getting that 73 is the quotient and 1 as the remainder, that one we people are taking it outside. Next is, and this goes on process, means we are just going on dividing the quotient, whatever you people have got, and we people going on taking off the remainder part, and at last what we will be getting is the term is what, 1. So 1 divided by 2 is what, so it is not be divided, and we people are repeating getting a quotient as 0 and 1 here. So these are the terms, and it is been represented by from bottom to top, not from top to bottom. So what are the terms at the last, what we people are being dividing, that part will be acting as the first thing, and the that is MSB to LSB. MSB means most significant bit to the least significant bit, that is, so we keep going from bottom to top. The 294 its value will be what, 100100100 to the base 2. Okay, so if we just multiply it, so we'll be getting what, 2 raised to 0 is 1, 2 raised to 1 is 2, 2 raised to 4, 2 raised to 8, 16, like that. If we just going on terms, we will be getting, if we add up all the terms, we will be getting it as 294 to the base 10. Okay, next. So same part, so when you convert to the fractional part, that decimal number 0.625 to the base 10 to binary. Once again, the radix part is what here? 2. So we are just multiplying, that is 0.625 into 2. So I am getting it as 1.25. So whatever the result, whatever we are getting the extra, but that is 1. We are taking that as a product, and we people are been keeping it in a binary value. So once again, next is multiplied by the remaining part, that is 0.25 into 2. I am getting it as 0.50. So the 0 value, the product value will be just taken out, and its value will be what, 0. Next, 0.5 into 2 is what, 1.0. Next, we, the product part, we are taking it as 1. So for the fractional part, what we are doing is we are getting from bottom to, top to bottom, that is 101. So if you just want 0.625, the base 10 will be what, 0.101. From top to bottom we should be getting the value, that is LSB is 1, 0 and MSB is 1. Okay, next. So in this fashion also we can just divide, or we can just go in this fashion also. The same steps, we are just, instead of table, they are just given a normal thing, that is 12 divided by 2 is what, so 12.125 is the integer part as well as the fractional part, they are given to the base 10 to binary. So the radix part is what here, 2. We are just taking the, that 12 divided by 2 is quotient is 6, remainder is 0. We are just taking it the remainder 0. Once again, the quotient 6 is divided by 2, then quotient is 3, remainder is 0. Once again, the 3 is divided by 2, quotient is 1, remainder is 1. So 1 divided by 2, quotient is, actually it should be 0, and the remainder is 1. So the value will be what, 1100. 12 to the base 10 is 1100. That is, its value will be what, 1, 2, 4, and 8. That is, 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. The same fashion, point for 125, it will be what, 125 to the base 10 to the radix, to the base, that is the radix part is 2. We are just multiplying it, so we are getting it as 125 into 2 is what, 0.25. So the carry output will be what, 0. Once again, that 0.125 is being multiplied by 2, so we will be getting it as 0.5. Once again, the carry is what, 0, that is 0.5 will be getting, so it will be 0. Next is what, 0.5 into 2 is 1.0, so the carry will be 1. So the result is 0.125 is 0.001 to the base 2, and the last result, therefore the final result will be what, 12.125, what we will be getting is 1100.001 to the base 2. Okay, or, so this one is a common procedure what we people will be just following for the conversion from decimal to binary. Okay, so this one is a normal form, so it is very easy to do the stuffs. Okay, so for the same thing we are just taking another example, that is 47.598. so 47 is the thing, the decimal number, we are just dividing by, to conversion part is what, 2. So just dividing, that is 2 divided by 47 is 23, the remainder is 1. So if once again, if you do 23 divided by 2, we will be getting it as 12. So its value is 1600, like this. So we will be writing from what, top to bottom, that is 1100 11 to the base 2, and the fractional part is what, 0.598 into 2, that will be getting it as 1.196. once again, so 1 is been, so whatever the red mark is been, then we are just taking it as to the first term, that is 1. So once again, 1.96 into 2 is what, 0.392. so 0 has been taken out. Once again, 39.2 into is, that is 0.784. so okay, so we can just go for 3 to 4 steps. So what will be value will be getting is 0.598 to the base 10 is 0.100 to the base 2. So the total answer for 47.59 to the base 10 is, so its value is, the binary value is 110011.100 to the base 2. Okay, so another important what you should be remembering in convergence means, so if they tell you to convert to the binary convergence, so binary means all the terms should be having only the two values, 0 and 1. Okay, so sometimes they'll be getting giving the values 47.598, not, they'll not be bringing any of the base. So you should be just checking, so which is the highest number. So here we are getting it as 9, so it will be of a decimal number, that you should be, care should be taken. Okay, next, the same procedure is being followed for any of the number to the octal. See, so convert decimal to octal, 128.125 decimal to octal. Octal means to the base 8, the radix part is what, 8. So once again, the same procedure what you people have been done for the binary form, that is 128 by 2 8 is, quotient is 16, so remainder is 0. So we are concentrating on what, the remainder. Next, 16 divided by 8 is what, quotient is 2, remainder is 0. So 2 divided by 8 is, quotient is 0, and the remainder is 2. So its value will be what, so for the fractional integer part, what from we will get it from bottom to top, that is its value of 12 to the base 10 is what, 200 to the base 8. Next, same thing for 1.125 into 8 is 1.0 is the carry, since one thing multiplied by 8 for the next step is will be 0 only, so we will be getting it as only one value, that is 1. So its value, the final value is 128.125 is 200.1 to the base 8. Okay, see, so normal steps what you people will be following is, so next example is 765.245 to the base 10. So 26765 divided by 8, so we're getting it as 895, and it's 760. So its value will be, the remainder value will be 5, and 811 is 88, its remainder is 7, 81 8, and its remainder is 3, and the next term is, see, so the terms what you will be writing it as 1375, that is 137.5. same thing, next 2.245 is, so we're just multiplying the 245 into 8 is 1.966, 1 is will taking out, and next 960 will be what, 6 into 8 will be 7.680, 7 will be taking out, next 680 into 8 is 5.440. so nearly for 3 to 4 steps you calculate, and for 0.245 its value is 0.175 to the base L 8, and if you just go on adding for the final result, its value will be what, for 762.245 to the base 10 is 1375.175 to the base 8. Since it is a base 8, its maximum value what will be having is 7, not more than 7. Next, same thing, so conversion of decimal number to hexadecimal, same. So hexadecimals, it should be dividing by 16 and multiplying by 16. For integer part, you should be dividing by 16. For fractional part, it should be multiplying by 16. Okay, next. So 294 divided by 16 is, the quotient is 18. Remainder is 6. We are taking out the 6 value. Next, 18. Whatever the quotient, whatever you got, divided by 16 is 1 to 6. So your value will be what? 1 to 6, that is from top bottom to top it will be what? 1 to 6. Its value will be what? 1 to 6 to the base 16, and the one is 1625 to the base 10 to hexadecimal is 0.625 into 16 is what? What will be getting is 10.0. The product is been 10. 10 means in hexadecimal I should be representing it as A. So the result of 0.625 to the base 10 is what? 0.A to the base 16. So I can't represent it as 10, because since it is hexadecimal, for 10 it has been represented by A. That care should be taken. Next, the same 128.125 decimal to hexadecimal, same thing. 128 by 16 is what? Quotient is 8, remainder is 0. 8 divided by 16 we can take possible, so quotient is 0, remainder is 8. So what are we getting is 128 to the base 10 is 80 to the base 16. In the same fashion, for 125 into 16 is 2.0, so carry it is, we will be getting it the value as 0.2. So total value of 128.125 to the base 10 is 80.2 to the base 16. Okay, next. So until now what you can, so we have converted the decimal number to binary, octal as well as hexadecimal. Next, the vice versa process, that is binary to other system. Binary to decimal, binary to octal, binary to hexadecimal. Okay, next. So what we are converting is, so binary to decimal, that is 10110.110 to the base 2 is equal to what? To a decimal number. So its value will be what you will be getting. So we will just taking the radix point, that is base to the weight, that is 2 raised to 0 position, 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4. So these are the values what you will be having, 10110. So we are just taking the point, that is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 square, 2 cube, as well as 2 raised to 4. 2 raised to 0 means its value will be, obviously it will be 1, 2, 4, 8 as well as 16. Since it has been multiplied by 0, we are getting it as 0, 1 by 1, 2, 1 into 2 square is 4, 0 into 8 is 0, 1 into 16. So if we add up, we will be getting the value it as 22, and for 0.25, that is 2 raised to, that is 110, 1 into 2 raised to minus 1 plus 1 into 2 raised to minus 2 plus 1 into 2 raised to minus 3. Its value will be 1 raised to minus 1 is 1 divided by 2 is 0.5, 1 divided by 4 is 0.25. If I add up, we will be getting it as 0.75. So if you just do it, so we will be getting it as 10101101 to the base 2 is 22.75. So whatever the value, whatever we have got is right or wrong, we can cross check by what? We can cross check by 22 if we just go on dividing by 2. So we'll be getting the value it as 10110 for successive division, as well as 0.75 into 2, I'll be getting it as 110. You can just cross check like that. Next. So whatever it means, binary to octal. So by octal means we'll be having the values from 0 to 7. If I want to represent it in a binary position, what it will be? So the terms will be what? 000, 001, 00010, 011, 100, 110, as well as for 7 it will be 111. So we will be grouping of the 3 bits. Since it is an octal, we are converting it, group it in a 3 bits, prefix the required number 0, then the value is not the change. Means if we just add, for example, so only the remaining bits will be 2 values, then we can add a previously evaluate as 0 for the integer part, and for fractional part you should be added up after the fractional bit number, as well as the group the given digit or bit from LHS to RHS above the point bit at. If the last group is not equal to 3 bits position, the required numbers of zeros and the values will not be changed. Means if you add zeros, the values will not be changed. So write the corresponding equivalent number for each group, gives the octal dependent of binary digit. So this one is just the theoretical part how to convert. So you'll just check an example. So in this you will be getting to know how it exactly it will be just. Next. Example of binary to octal. So this is the number what they have given. So 10101 to the base 2. So 10100 to the base 2 is octal. So we are just dividing the groups here from, so this one is a integer part. So what will be giving from LHS to RHS will be just going left hand side to the right hand, that is LSB to the MSB. The first three bits are being grouped, that is 1011. Next is what? 010. Next is 01. Only 01 is been. So we are just adding up another 0. So no problem about this one because the value will be remain 6. So 110 will be what's value will be? 110 means 4 plus 2 is 6. 010 its value will be what? 2. And 010 it will be 2. So its value will be what? 1010 10110 to the base 2 will be what? Its value will be 226 to the base 8. Means whenever they will be giving a binary number conversions directly, we can just group the by 3, we will be getting the octal number. Or so what we can do? Okay, so this one is a easier step, so we can just group it. Or we can also divide means, so first whatever the binary number we people will be getting, that we people will be converting into a decimal number. After decimal number, once again we are converting the same octal form, that is successive division or the successive multiplication form. Same thing, 1 into 2 raised to 7 plus 0 into 2 raised to 6. So from, if I just go to the position 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1 like this, if I just go, so its value will be 150 to the base 10. So 150 to the base 10 means, once again I should divide 150 divided by 2, its value will be what? 622. So we are getting from bottom to top, so its value will be what? 226 to the base 2. So if you whichever you feel easy, you can just go for it. Okay, so if you just grouping by 3 bits, then it is a direct method. Or else we can convert the given binary number first to a decimal number, then convert the decimal number to a octal number by successive division or the successive multiplication. Okay, so this one is just a simple example. So what it will be, so how we are assuming the 0, so 10110.010. So it should be for 3 bits, so I should have added up a 0 here. Next, from LHS to RHS, so 011, so 3 bits, 01, so remaining bit is what? The 0, it has been added up, so its value will be what? 110 means 4 plus 2 is 6, so 010 is 2. So same example what it has been taken previously. Okay, so we have added up here also 0 as well as the same thing. Okay, so what they have been represented by the fractional part, and here it is not been represented by a fractional part. Okay, see the octal part value 0 is been represented, binary is 000. For 1 it is 001, that is 010, that is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, that is 1, 2, 4. So we are just going on, and 2 means 2 value, 3 means what? 2 plus 1, 2 plus 1 is 3, 4 means directly represent, 5 means 4 plus 1, 4 value will be there here, it will be represented by 1, that is 4 plus 1, 6 is 4 plus 2, for 7 it will be what? All bits 1, that is 4 plus 2 plus 1, 1, 1, 1. Next, binary to hexadecimal. So the procedure is been same for binary to octal as well as the hexadecimal. Only thing is, in octal we just grouping by 3 bits, but in hexadecimal we people are been grouping by 4 bits. That is the main difference. Remaining all procedure is same. Means if we are just having a less number of bits, then we should be adding zeros for the integer part to the left hand part. For the fractional part, it should be at the right hand part. Okay, see, it's the same value what it will be converted, 1000101. So we just go on grouping. So since it is 8 bits, so directly we can group it 4 bits, 0110 1001. So 0110 its value is what? That is 4 plus 2 is 6, 8 plus 1 is 9, grouping by 4 bits. So its value will be 96 to the base 16. Or else, first what you should doing is convert that binary number to a decimal number, then decimal number to a hexadecimal number, that is by successive division divided by 150 to the base divided by 16, which we'll be getting. So where the value will be what? 96 to the base 16. We can go for this direct method, that is by grouping by 4 or by converting binary to decimal, then decimal to hexadecimal. So whichever you feel easy, you can go for it. Okay. Okay, same thing, binary takes and decimals, adding of 0, assuming of the 0. So why people are going going for grouping of 4 means, see, 0 to 16, that is 0 to 15 means f is, should be represented by what, 1 1 1. For that reason it is been just taken. Okay, so 0 means 4 bits, 0 0 0 0 0 1. For a it is 10, that is 1 0 1 0. 8 plus 2 is a. Next, b means 11, that is 8 plus 2 plus 1, that is 11. For c it is 12, that is 8 plus 4, and d is 13. 8 plus 4 plus 1 is really what, 13. And for e is what, 1 1 1 0, that is 8 plus 4 plus 2. 8 plus 4 12, 12 plus 2 is 14. And for the last f will be what, 1 1 1 1, that is 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 8 plus 4 is 12, 12 plus 2 is 14, 14 plus 1 is 15. Its value will be thing. Next, octal to number system. So what is the terms? Next, so same thing, octal to decimal, octal to binary, octal to hexadecimal. So it is also the same procedure what people will be following, what people have been done for the decimal part. So there what people have converted in decimal part, to any of the numbers if you want to convert to a decimal part, what people are doing is what, so that has been converted by using the 10. See, and the radix part here it will be what, 8. Okay, so means the 345 to the decimal means it was been 3 into 10 raised to 2, that is the position what people have been studied initially. But here it since after, then what it will be, 3 into 8 square plus 4 into 8 raised to 1 plus 5 into 8 raised to 0, and its value will be what, 229 to the decimal. Okay, instead of 10 we people have been taking for 8. So whatever the part what they are, 345 to the base 8, so whatever the base they have taken, we have been multiplying with the unit weights. Next, octal to binary, octal is 3 4 5. Okay, see, 3 4 5. Binary, 3 is represented what value, 011, 4100, 5 101. If you just group together, then it will be what, to the base 2. So when we convert a binary to octal, what people have done is the binary number was been grouped by 3 bits, the same thing. So we are representing the octal numbers by binary value. So 3 means octal means you should be having a group of 3. So we are representing 3 value, it as 011, 4 as 100, 5 as 101. If you want, if you should be remembering this table for octal as well as the hexadecimal. Next is octal, yeah, octal to hexadecimal. So what we people are doing is we are grouping it by 4 bits. For octal you are grouping it by 3 bits. For hexadecimal you people are been grouping by 4 bits. So 3 well, so 3 is what, 011. 4 is 100, 5 is 101. So this is the binary value. So we are just grouping it by 1. 0101111. So 0 is be there. So remaining 3 zeros have just been added. Okay, 0. And its value is 111 means 8 plus 4 plus 2. Its value is 14. That is, it is represented by E. And why 0101 means 4 plus 1 is 5. So its value of 345 to the base A is E, 5 to the base 16. Okay, and normally what the most students what will be doing is, so they will not be representing by E. Since it is a hexadecimal, it should be representing by E, not by the value as 14. Okay, that care should be taken. So here also the missing zeros, how the missing zeros have been added up. Okay, so if it is of a hexadecimal, so we should be grouping with the 4 bits. Okay, binary to other numbers. So hexadecimal to decimal, hexadecimal to binary, hexadecimal to octal, same thing. Hexadecimal to decimal means same thing. So whatever the steps what you have been converting from decimal octal, so the same things what you'll be doing is 7 into the means whatever the hexadecimal means is to 16 raised to square plus 13 into 16 raised to 1 plus 14 into 16 raised to 0, that is 7 into 256, 16 square is 256 plus 13 into 16 plus 14 into 1. So if we just go on adding up, we'll be getting it as 2014 in decimal number. So 70 to the base 16 is 2014. 1 4 to the base. So next, hexadecimal to binary. So whatever the number they are given, so they are given it as 4FA to the base 16 to binary. So 4 value, or how you can representing, since it's the hexadecimal, it should be represented by using 4 bits. 4 means 0110. F means what? 15. Its value is 15, so it is represented as 1111, and A value is 10. That is 1010. If you group together, you will be getting it as 10011110 to the base. Okay. Next, hexadecimal to octal. So first thing. So it's one of the simplest term. So convert means first you can convert that directly to the binary form, then grouping by 3 bits it will be converted into a octal form. 1BC is one value is represented as 0001. B means what? 11. Its value is 1011. C means 12. That is 1100. Group together, so you'll be getting 001101111100. Then we can be grouping with the 3 bits from the left hand part, that is 001 111 011 000. So its value will be what? 00 value will be 0, 110 is 4 plus 2 is 6, 111 means 7, 100 is 4. Its value will be what? 0674. Neglecting 0, what we can do is 674 to the base 8. Okay, so these are the conversions, and this one is the table what the decimal number of the binary octal as well as the hexadecimal, how it can be represented. 0 means 000 001 010 until 111 means, if you are just going on binary means, we should be adding up the term, that is 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. So 1 represents what? 1. 2 represents the 2. 3 represents 2 plus 1. 3, like that. If you are just going octal, 00 to 07, and the 8 part is represented as 10, like that. We're just going as well as the hexadecimal is 0 to 15, that is 0 to F. Okay, so what are the hints to conversion? So we are at the end of this session. So what are the conversions, whatever people have been done? Okay, so what are the procedure, what should be the others to decimal? Any numbers means whether it might be binary, octal or hexadecimal, we should convert to a decimal form means we should multiply. Decimal to others means it should be dividing. So whatever the number, if they are given the decimal numbers, then you should be dividing the process, then you will be getting the binary form, octal form or the hexadecimal form. So binary to hexadecimal means it's a group of 4. Binary to octal means it's a group of 3. Hexadecimal to octal, first the hexadecimal should be converted to a binary form, then binary to octal. Octal to hexadecimal means same thing. Octal to binary we should convert, then to hexadecimal. Octal to binary means first you should be going on dividing by 2, or directly the number, the binary value will be remembering, those values should be writing, and then grouping has to be done. Okay, so this one is the session 1 of your module 5 of a number system, and in this system we people have been using what? The number system, that is decimal, binary, octal and hexadecimal. So we're just converting all the terms the as vice versa, that is decimal to binary, decimal to octal, decimal to hexadecimal and vice versa. Means any of the number they will give, they can just, it can be converted to any form. Okay, so this is the steps what you should be following. Okay, thank you.